Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? On December 21st at 1711 Universal Time, the winter solstice occurs for the Northern Hemisphere. So what can we expect to see in the sky for the coming season? In the north, around 9 p.m., the circumpolar stars, for many of us well north of the equator, rotate 90 degrees or so from December to March. Cassiopeia begins the season high to the northwest, with the easily seen Big Dipper or Plow low to the northeast. Directly north, Kochab hangs below Polaris, with the seemingly blank Camelopardalis and Lynx section of the sky above the North Star. Fast forwarding 3 months, Cassiopeia drops, Ursa Major rises, and Kochab is now towards the east. This is evidence of our planet having revolved 90 degrees over those 3 months, with its axis still pointing in the same direction. To the west, many autumn favorites are visible early, such as Pegasus and Andromeda, so look for the sights within their borders in early winter. As the season progresses, many of the dimmer water constellations like Pisces, Cetus, and Eridanus replace them, but a fair number of the prominent winter constellations aren't far behind. We'll look at the constellations to the south next. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. A sunset glow has redshifted light. This helps your body recognize nighttime coming. But computer screens have blue-shifted light, so download the free program Flux to automatically change your computer screen every day to redshifted light when the light outside does, at sunset. Orion, perhaps the most easily recognized pattern in the sky, graces the southeast. Orange-appearing Betelgeuse is the bright star at the Hunter's shoulder on the left, and blue-white Rigel is at his knee to our right. The nearly straight and similarly bright belt stars help us locate several winter constellations nearby to Orion. Up and to the right of the belt is Aldebaran, the red giant symbolizing the eye of Taurus. The bull appears to protect the seven sisters of the Pleiades from the Hunter, although this does not entirely follow the mythology of these characters. Down and to the left of the belt is the brightest nighttime star in the sky, Sirius, punctuating the Hunter's dog Canis Major. 25 degrees up from Sirius and away from Orion is first magnitude Procyon, one of the two stars that marks the unremarkable Canis Minor. But swinging up and over Orion from there is Gemini, the twins. Normally we would be excited about the similarities and differences of Castor and Pollux, but a brighter visitor graces the twins all season long. Jupiter slides its way through here during winter. As if rounding out a circle, one of the brightest stars in the northern hemisphere, Capella, helps us find Auriga. This constellation appears to share a star with Taurus, with Alnath often forming not only a horn of the bull, but completing the shape of Auriga, though the reality is the star is Beta Tauri. So Auriga loses out there. All of these stars move quickly across the sky in winter, so look for objects within them as they cross or are near the meridian, and they will arrive there earlier in the evening as the season grows later. Towards the east, the stars of spring are making their way up from the horizon, the ones of the most interest to us being Cancer, Leo, Canis Venatici, and Coma Berenices. On Tuesday, the moon is both full, but also a few days before apogee, giving us the smallest full moon of 2013, or a mini-moon. In the evening, Venus goes on an extreme diet, slimming down from 17 to 11% illumination, yet growing in angular diameter from 48 arc seconds to 53 arc seconds. Use a small telescope to see that change. An hour before sunrise, Spica splits the distance between Saturn, closer to the horizon, and Mars, further west along the ecliptic. As for outer gas giant stargazers, Uranus crosses the border of Cetus into Pisces near the fifth magnitude star 44 Piscium. Neptune sets earlier in the evening 3.5 degrees from Theta Aquarii. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes in the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller, wishing you clear and dark skies.